So, check this out.
My high school football game got shut up.
So please come back. Please bring back.
My high school football.
Wait.
Yeah, did you just see what I just saw? Did you just see that? Everybody on the football field is laying down. A high school football game is shot up. Where it is at? I don't know. Now, I don't know how I feel about this.
I'm serious.
I got like mixed feelings. You know what I mean? Cause are they done and y'all just laying there waiting on them to just come pick you off, or who initiated this protocol? I don't know how I feel. It made me think about back in the days when we were in high school, right? Uh-huh. You ever went, got dropped off to the football games on Friday night?
Mm-hmm.
Imagine getting word that your child is there during a shootout. Your child's football game got shot up. You wasn't there. You dropped them off to attend the football game. Bro, whew.
Maybe it was fireworks.
Okay, so They got you with these fireworks. They've been blasting off for New Year's, huh?
Yes.
They
got you. Oh my gosh. Got you thinking
everything is fireworks now.
Maybe it was because
don't become one of those people.
Because I'm like, my thing is,
I've never experienced nothing.
Seen people respond like that. Well, it's nobody. It looks like nobody's in the stands. So.
Oh yeah, yeah. It looked like everybody gone, dispersed.
So it's only the people that's on the field still out.
Everybody else dispersed, but it's looking like the people who was on the field didn't have time.
Yeah, so they just lay down.
They was like, "Get down, everybody down," because they probably didn't know where the shots was coming from.
So you didn't think to run?
That's a fact.
Like I know they taught stop, drop, and roll. But
that's a fire.
No, but that wasn't for guns.
That's for fire, not gunfire. I mean, that's for fire.
I'm like, wait.
Nah, man. I don't know. Okay. I might have been low key mad when I pulled up and seen my son laying down on the field.
Like what the?
I know. I taught you survival skills better than that.
Like you ain't even under nothing. You ain't under a desk, a bench, or nothing.
Out in the open.
I'd
have been straight up hot, fam.
Yeah.
Like, we'd have went
home.
You're
not even crawling or nothing. You're not inching. You're not nothing. You just playing dead? What is that?
Okay. Yeah, we'd have had a long talk when we got home, bro.
Yeah.
Like, you.
I don't know about that.
That's, you got to have some street smarts, son. Like, you might got book smarts, but.
They were playing dead. That's what it was.
They got my kid out there playing dead?
Yeah.
Bro, this ain't no Walking Dead movie. This ain't no zombie movie. We ain't playing dead.
Because nobody shoots at the ground unless you know.
Bullets ricochet. Bullets.
Yeah.
Bullets go. People don't always have the best aim. You see a lot of these movies. People go to shoot and they go everywhere.
Right.
Like, no.
And depending on what type of gun they got, if they don't have control, you know, they that gun could just be moving them everywhere.
I don't like it, but at the same time,
I'm just like, dang.
I get a little bit of it. I understand. This is scary. I know we're making light of the situation, but at the end of the day, this is scary, fam.
That's what I'm like. I'm really.
What type
I see it says trending news football game.
This was back in September, though.
I know. But I really don't see where no one else confirmed that. That's why I'm like, maybe
this is a movie. Maybe this is a movie.
That's why I'm like, so maybe.
Hopefully this is a movie.
It was a misunderstanding.
Because you would like to think. But this is the world we live in, so you can't really put it past anybody, bro.
True.
Like, they'll shoot up.
They don't care no more.
They shooting up the inside of school. What's the outside? What they scared of?
True.
Like, and it's just sad that we gotta experience stuff and see stuff like this, man.
Nothing's off limits.
That's scary. Now you're already dealing with at what everybody's home for now with these sicknesses. You're dealing with that right now. So school's already different for the kids that's going to school now.
Right.
They're already shuffling between being at school or not being at school, being virtual or being at school, possibly risking whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They had to deal with that. They had to deal with, you know what I mean, having to possibly forego your senior graduation because of the sickness that's going. Like,
it's just too much.
They've gone through enough. And now, you know what I mean? School shootings haven't just started. They've been going on since forever. But just to have to deal with that type of stuff too.
I think it's traumatizing. It's interesting that before, it's like the people that are doing it now too, it's like they're changing, you know? It's more of the younger crowd and some of the people that are actually in the school with them. Because I know recently there was a video, and my sister actually shared it with me, and me and my boys actually got to watch it, where the kids were in the classroom, and I forgot where it was, but the boy was knocking on the door trying to get them. He was impersonating an officer, trying to get them to open the door. And he was telling them, like, it's the officer, you know, it's safe, and trying to get them to come out. But he made a mistake and said, bro, instead of talking like a formal officer. And they caught it. And they was like, no, you heard him. And they freaked out and they ran out the back door. And you should, like, it was just, like, chills. And even just talking about it right now gives me chills. But even Zaire was like, that is so freaky.
That's scary, man.
And they ran to, you know.
Did y'all have protocols in place that y'all discussed when you were in school? Because I don't remember none.
I know, no.
Only thing we were worried about was the when they did the drug bust. That was it.
I remember tornadoes.
That was it. We ain't never discussed no school shooter or nothing like that. We never discussed anything like that. No. In our school. Mm-mm. So we weren't prepared. Now, we did have a situation once where a boy tried to bring something and he had like a little list or whatever, but we never, even after that, they didn't, put protocols in place or nothing. They were just so old school. Mm-mm. They didn't have that. We didn't have the metal detectors for people to walk through.
Nope.
We had like an old security guard some days being at the gym, and when you came to the gym, he warned you every now and again. But that wasn't standard practice. It wasn't all the time. So I don't know, man. This is crazy, man.
I think we had just started getting to the point to where, even if you started like fighting, like, and I'm talking about fighting with your like physical fighting, which is just your fists, you would like get arrested, you know? Like, but now things are getting just crazy.
It's to the point where you think this stuff is just going like,
I don't think it's gonna die down, like, for some reason. And I feel like too, a lot of it, because even when I started talking to Zion about it, Zion was telling me, you know, like in his, cause, and that wasn't this year, that was last year when me and him was talking about it. And that's seventh grade at the time, middle school, how bad some of his friends in one of his older schools were getting bullied. And that's the school we had moved out of. And he was like, it's just so sad that how many of them commit suicide over there. And I was like, what? And when he started telling me, this here kid was getting bullied and they felt bad. And I'm like, what?
I'll never forget. I ain't gonna say his name, but we were in school, high school, buddy of ours collectively, more so my other homeboy, but you know, once you come into the crew, we all get to know you. We all riding around with you. He was the only one at the time that had a vehicle. You know what I mean? The old school van. He had the old school van with the beat in it. He had beat in the van, so it was crazy. We was wilding, but he had a vehicle. You know what I'm saying? So we all chilling and getting to know him, all that kind of stuff. We all chilling with each other, getting to know each other. And then, man, to hear he went to the baseball grounds on Mill Creek.
Oh, I love that part.
He went out to that park on the baseball fields and she killed herself on the pitcher's mound. Man, when we got that news, you talking about somebody was devastated. We was always around him. You know what I'm saying? Wow. He was always around us after we got to know him. And to hear that happen, bro, in the middle of school, that was crazy. Crazy. Right. Two beautiful daughters he had. Crazy.
That's why it's so sad, because it's like sometimes, you know, you don't understand it. Like, who did this event, you know, or who is doing the other things? But these kids be mean to each other. And sometimes it could be things stemming at home or things stemming from other things that we don't even know or don't even take time to even try to dig deep to figure out. And it's not intentional. It's because we're busy. But sometimes we got to stop and ask ourselves and kind of dig or just ask, you know, ask those questions to make them open up. Because it's things happening that we don't know why. And then it's like all of a sudden we'd be like, just what the heck, you know?
Because I can identify that. You know, I ain't always run home and talk to my folks about what happened in school. I didn't. Whatever happened. And, you know, if we did something, if I did something bad, I was hoping they didn't find out. Right. And if I was involved in something, I was hoping, you know, I handled it myself is the way I thought.
Right.
But trying to get a child these days and kids to realize it's okay to speak to your parents, it's tough. It's not an easy thing. You know what I'm saying? Trying to get them to open up, speak to you, it's an ongoing process.
It is.
It's definitely on. And it's times that he may want to speak to you and not me, or me and not you.
Right.
It's ever-changing.
We have experienced that. Yes. Remember we did that? Because we had that issue with Zaire. And it's like, then he was having an issue in school, you know, and was trying to handle it himself. And then I was trying to talk to him. And the whole time, I kind of was feeling something was going on. But he wouldn't tell me. And he's like, because I knew you would go off. And I'm like, because I'm your mother.
But then y'all put it in my lap. And I ended up going to the school. And that's when I caught the coach coming out to school.
Right.
Yeah, that wasn't
a... Exactly. And I'm like, you'd have told me that I'd have went off. But I'd have went off in a different, you know, manner. I'm like, see there?
That was not a nice situation, but I hope and pray that nobody was injured here. I hope everybody was okay.
Yeah.
And if we can figure out, but that's another thing. Didn't we used to have police officers at the games?
Yes, they normally do. That's why I'm like, because
we used to have a lot of police officers at the game. So where was the police at? Hopefully they stopped it. Got to it pretty quick. And
that's what I'm saying. I hope and pray that this, you know, because sometimes social media can't exaggerate things.
True.
So I'm really hoping.
This was a TikTok moment?
Yeah. That it's just appearing that, it was shots, but it really wasn't.
It was a TikTok.
You know,
it was just like, that's a sick joke then.
A serious, you know, a car backfired, you know?
You can tell we come from the country.
You can tell we was down in a small city.
Yeah, I mean, when you say, yo, that could have been a car that backfired, everybody on the ground, get up, what y'all doing? Bruh.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Hopefully everybody was safe, man.
Right.
Y'all let us know how y'all feel about this. And I hope...
check on the kids. Like, this here's a good moment. This here, let this clip, you know, even though we're making light of the situation, because you always got to find something,
if
you know, positive in life, because there's so much negative to look at. Let's not try to focus on that. Let's try to take this moment and focus on something, you know, and find reasons to check on our young ones. Check on the little ones, you know, or the high schoolers, or how Zaire says, a young adult. Check on the young adults.
Y'all get at us, man. Let's see y'all in the comment section.